Hi, how are you? Good afternoon. I'm going to make sambar today. Well, I'm not. My mom's going to teach me how to make sambar. It's a South Indian vegetable stew, but it's actually lentils and a lot of veggies. And it's a curry that you use for dips or you have it with rice, but it is really tasty. Today we're going to make drumstick leaf sambar and I'm going to take you to the kitchen shortly. We are in the kitchen. We start off with the base, which is lentils. So this one is tur dal. We've soaked it and then we've boiled it in the pressure cooker with some turmeric, salt, a little bit of oil, and asafoetida, which is this little thing here. It's essential in every South Indian cooking. Then some fenugreek, salt, tamarind soaked in water. Essentials that we always see in any sort of cooking: onions, tomatoes, chili, and curry leaves. Then this is our vegetable for the sambar today. It's drumstick leaves already soaked and taken off the branches. Famous family chili powder. And here the masala box, of which we're only going to use the turmeric and then the mustard seeds. There you go. In a little bit of oil, put some mustard seeds and some fenugreek and then some onion. My mum is going to be the hand model today. Okay, that's my hand. We'll reduce the flame a little bit. It's a bit too high. So she's put the chilies as well. Let this cook for a bit, saute. Once the onions are slightly sauteed brownish, you'll know when it's cooked. Add the tomatoes, curry leaves, a little bit of salt. Saute it and then close it so that it cooks. Now that the tomatoes are soft, the next step is to add the drumstick leaves. You can add lady's finger, drumsticks, any other vegetable, beans, carrots. But the way we do it, or the way my mom is doing it at the moment, is not to put the masalas first. So once the tomatoes are done, add this or any vegetable, as I said. I'll add the rest later. Saute it. Mark, can you do it? Add a tiny bit of salt. Okay, that doesn't look tiny. Add a little bit of salt. Some turmeric. And our family's chili powder. Looks like a lot, but it actually isn't very spicy. Spicy in terms of the heat, it isn't. So I'll mix it all thoroughly. Once you've mixed all the powders, add a little bit of water. I'm using proper. Yeah. Let it cook for a bit. Remember the tamarind that I showed you that was soaked? You basically now, once while the leaves or your vegetable is cooking, you can use that time to drain all the juice out of the tamarind. Okay, and some people would just sieve it using their fingers, but you could use a strainer like this. This is, and then let it drip at the bottom. Use your fingers to just get all the juices out and then it'll be done. Just gonna wait for that. Now let's check how this has been boiling. We checked a bit earlier. The leaves have cooked, so make sure your veggies are cooked, whatever you add. Okay, now it's time to add the tamarind water that you just drained. Now we'll add the dal that we've already cooked. Add a little bit of water to what's remaining in the pan. So it's been boiling for the last 2 minutes, I think. As final touches, add a little bit of ghee. if it decides to come up, when it decides to come up. You can also add this in your individual plate, okay? I'll add the rest later. And then a little bit of hing or asafoetida. It's a funky spelling. Mm-hmm. Okay, mom said that's enough. And then finally, if you've got shop bought or if you've made it at home, only a teaspoon of sambar powder. Okay, that much. That's enough. Now mix the whole thing up. Okay, so mix this up for another 2 minutes. Let it boil. Let all the powders mix within the sambar itself properly. And it's ready to be served. That's all. Check the salt. Yeah, don't forget. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you.